Well, today I had to freshen up the inside and the outside of an old foundation, and I used this UGI dry lock. A lot of people ask me about it, so I figured I'd do a little video on it. Here we go. Well, today I got this job to come down here and paint the inside of the basement. Now, a lot of times you see in my videos I use Portland cement, a white Portland, but today's a little different. I'm actually going to use a little paint, and I'm going to show you how I did it and then look at it at the end. Also, we're going to go outside here and patch up this foundation right here. See, got some issues going on here. It's the old cement and coal foundation. We're just going to patch that up. Over here you can see the paint came off. We're going to paint that up too. And same thing on this side of the house. I'm going to get rid of this paint. Inspectors don't go for this when they're inspecting houses. They don't like to see chipped paint. It's always a big issue. So we're going to patch it up, show you how I did that.
Now, there's a couple things I do and what I look for. This is like a mold, and there's good mold and there's bad mold. Everybody's going to tell you something different, but I already pre-tested it, and I know it's like a little mold, so we don't want to paint over that. So I just get some regular water, get a scrub brush, and I scrub it off. That's all I want to do. I scrub it off. I get down to the white. I'm gonna get my sponge. I rip these out of old car seats or things, and I just wipe it off. And then I'm gonna do the whole basement like that. You can see it even comes off with the sponge. I'm gonna do the whole basement like that, and then I'm gonna check for chipped paint. Now over here I got some paint that's fallen off. I'm just gonna chip it off. I'm not gonna make a big deal out of this. Just the loose stuff. You don't go to a dentist and he rips the whole tooth out. He just gets what's bad, and that's it. If it ain't bad, leave it there. Now you get a spot like this where it's falling off. You scrape it like that and get your wire brush and get the rest of it off. Anything that's loose. It's like if you're going to the dentist. You don't rip the whole tooth out, just the bad stuff. Going back a couple hours later, it's all dried off. I'm just going to paint over it. That's all. Just like that. I could tell you stories. I was in the Navy, early 70s. Painting. We used to paint the ship every 2 weeks. Unless we were out at sea. When we were out at sea, you'd be painting the superstructure. And when you're in port, you paint the sides of the ship every 2 weeks. So we're going to do this first. And we're going to get all the bad spots first. That's what we want to do. Get all the bad spots first. And then let it dry up, come back and look at it and see if it needs a second coat. Very simple. Brushes for this kind of stuff is about the best, because you can get in there with the brush. You can't get in there with a roller. I very seldom use a roller. I don't waste my time. I can do it twice as fast and less mess with this stuff. Oh, we're back a day later. We're just going to go past the ghosty spots and just get them out of the way, that's all. And then this should be all dried up and looking good. It should all match. Now we came outside and we did the foundation. I'm going to show you how we did that.
Now this side, we're going to patch up this side. See it? This is all falling apart here. It's not bad up here. Just down here where the water freezes in the winter. And over here, you know, we got some paint. Get the paint off. Anything that's loose. And then like always, we just want to dig down below a little bit so we can get down in there and this ain't bad. This is all good. It's not good. Get the bad stuff off. Just patch up the good stuff, that's all. Drylock makes this fast plug hydraulic cement, and we're going to give this a shot. We're going to use it on the outside of the foundation. So I'm just going to wet it up first. That. See how it works out. Not bad. Now, as you can see, I got a little pasty, which is what I want. Then I want to wash this down, get all the dust off it. It has to be wet. And then we're just going to plaster it on like this. See, it has to be a certain thickness, just like that. If it gets in there, you could come back and straighten it out later. See? All you gotta do is get it in there first. And we're gonna keep going. Put it on there nice. Down over here, I'm gonna go over the paint and everything. It ain't gonna hurt nothing. It's getting a little stiffer. See? Just wanna get it in there. Fill those big holes up. Go right up in here into the paint. Fill them up too. No big deal. Little spot. Now we're doing making it look better, that's all. Not making a big deal out of it. Get it as flat as you can, you see? That's all. The other guy did the same thing. He was doing all different things. Now I'll go over it kind of lightly again. You'll see it start to stiffen up. As it starts to stiffen up, you could form it a little more, get the rough edges out of it. Then we're gonna sponge it. Now you can see it's getting a little creamy. Just want to get a sponge. Just run the sponge across it like that. And that's going to fill in all those holes and hide all those sins. If you want to put another coat over it, you could. We're just interested in painting it. I'm going to come back to paint this. So that's all we're doing. Look at that. Looks just like the rest. Looks better than the rest. And that's it. No big deal. So now we're going to take our dry lock and just start painting it. That's it. No big deal. We'll put a first coat on. I'm going to get all the bad spots first and then come back later on and put a second coat over the whole thing. We're going to get all the bad spots first. And this stuff is pretty good because it fills in a lot of little cracks. So, like I always say in my videos, no big deal. So we got it looking good. Painting over everything. Making it look good. A little brush for the bottom. Just like that. Now we did the bottom yesterday. Today I'm just scraping it up. All the loose stuff. Not gonna go crazy with it. Just gonna get the loose stuff off. Now, just this little bit that I did, kind of go both ways. See that? Now the great thing about the paint is it's thick. And it hides all that stuff in there. And when you put your second coat on, it really hides it. So that's a good thing about this paint. It's almost kind of sandy like. See that? It gets right in there. It hides all that stuff. Look at that. That's the first coat. When we put our second coat on, that's going to be looking good. So that's it. I finished downstairs and I came out and I did the walls and then I paint them. Sometimes you gotta paint over paint. I don't like putting cement over paint. In a situation like this, they just wanted to clean it up. They don't want no paint chips for the inspectors. The inspectors come around, they see paint chips. They say they got lead on them, it's a big deal. So it's just a cleanup job. So that's just what it is. It was like freshen it up. Because they were selling the house, and what happens is these inspectors will come in, say they send a bank inspector, and he'll go look at the house and he'll say, oh, you got paint chips, or you got this, or this is wrong. They always got to find something wrong because that's their job. So what I did was got rid of all the paint chips and everything, got rid of the mold, freshened it up, and it's good. Now, one of the things they asked me how good the dry lock is. Well, years ago, I did the inside of a garage and I laid stone up, you know, the stick-on stone, the real stuff. And in between that, they painted murals. And they asked me, what should I put on the foundation? And I said, well, try dry lock. And that's what they did. And they painted that mural over the top of it.
This is a stone job I did some years ago. And they did a mural on top of this. And behind this, we use UGI paint. So it worked out really well for that sort of thing. But there's nothing behind this wall. It's an open wall. There's no dirt or anything against it. But that was built over UGI paint.
So they did that mural before YouTube even started. So it lasted a long time. I don't use the product a lot because I'm really not a painter. I'm a mason. But I never heard anything bad about it. Well, thanks for watching. I'm Mike Haddock. Until next video.